glucose, sucrose, high fructose, sugar, you guys. It's all so taxing. Hey everyone, Laci Green here for DNews. Amidst all the sensationalism about the obesity epidemic, there lies a very important nugget of information. Americans now consume 39% more added sugars in our food than we did 50 years ago. Particularly, we consume way more high fructose corn syrup. That's why some experts say that sugary drinks like soda, energy drinks, and fruit juice cocktails are driving their own public health issues. This has led scientists to try to figure out how we can better curb our consumption of these sugary beverages, and one of the ways that's been proposed is higher taxes. Now, even saying the word tax is generally divisive here in the good old US of A, but a new study has found that a soda tax might actually come with health benefits. An international study based at the Health Economics Center at Monash University concluded that by upping the taxes on soda, people will lose weight, as much as 8 pounds a year for those who drink a lot of it. So in their analysis, they compared the economic effect of two types of taxes. The first was a 20% tax, and the second was a 20-cent tax per liter of soda. Both taxes are regressive, which basically means it affects the poor more than the wealthy, but those effects aren't overly pronounced in the study. With the 20% tax, the effect impacts all consumption levels with a similar force, whereas the benefit of a 20-cent tax is that the tax burden increases when you buy more of the drinks. For the 20% tax, people are projected to lose about 3 pounds or 1.3 kilos in a year. And those who drink a lot of soda could see that number doubled. The 20-cent tax had a more dramatic effect, kicking off an 8-pound weight loss or 3.6 kilos in a year. This was only for the middle class though. Why? Researchers at Duke found that for the rich, they're still gonna buy the soda either way. For the poor, they're more likely to strategize, things like buying in bulk or waiting for sales. So for both those groups, the health effects aren't as likely to kick in as the middle class. While these studies both find some health benefits, other studies have found that taxes won't encourage healthier habits. A recent study by health economists at the University of Iowa found that just because people are drinking less soda doesn't mean that they won't find more calories elsewhere. So, what do you think about the soda tax? Is it worthwhile if there's a public health benefit, or should people encourage to drink less soda on their own without the deterrence caused by taxes? Let me know what you think down below, and we'll see you next time with more DNews updates.